rose better not pick it, only grows when it's on the vine. Handful of thorns, no, you missed it, lose your love when you say the word mine.
So that chorus is from a video we recently published. Now, the chorus was constructed with the lead vocal double tracking just the chorus and two harmony tracks. The vocals were recorded in separate takes, so I needed to line them up. And to do this, I ended up using a two-step process. The first thing I did was use an automated script. However, after listening to the automated alignment, I decided to tighten up the vocals by doing a manual alignment process. This video is part two of a two-part series. In part one, I demonstrated how to set up shortcuts for Reaper stretch and take markers. In this video, I'll walk through how I lined up the vocals, first using the automated script, and then doing the manual alignment process. All right, so these are the three vocal chorus tracks. The light green track is the lead vocal doubling the chorus. And the two tracks in yellow, those are the harmony tracks. All right, so the idea is to line up the harmony tracks, you know, with the lead vocal. Now for the automated alignment, I used a script named MPL Align Takes. This is a free Reaper script from ReaPack.com. And I put links to the download and installation guide in the description. And it's a pretty easy install. I mean, the only issue I had was that after the install, I looked for the script in Reaper's plugin list, but it's referred to as a plugin throughout the documentation. But as it turns out, ReaPack scripts are listed in the action list. So just, you know, check out the action list, and that's where you'll find it. So let's take a look. Let's go to Actions, Show Action List. And here it is. It's I used Control-0 for my shortcut. You know, Reaper has a lot of keyboard controls defaulted, so you may need to play around a bit, you know, to find an available keyboard combo. But Control-0 was available, you know, in my installation. So let's close it up. So all right, let's listen to a bit of the raw takes. Here we go.
Love is a rose, it's better not pick it. Love is a rose, it's better not pick it.
Yeah, so you can hear that those takes are pretty much out of alignment. So let's do this automated script. So we do Control-0, which is my shortcut. Brings up the script. You know, and it's pretty sparse. It just has this get button. So the way this works is you want to right click, drag, and select the three tracks. And the way the script works is that it assumes that the top track is your reference track. So it is going to attempt to align tracks below it, in this case, these two harmony tracks, to the top track. So we just click on Get. And does its analysis. And then you have this slider. And what the slider does, it kind of gauges how much of the alignment you want to apply to the waveforms. You know, and the trade-off is the more alignment you apply, you may or may not end up introducing some distortion to the waveforms. So you kind of need to play around with the slider. Let's try there.
Love is a rose, it's better not pink. Love is a rose, it's better not pink.
Yeah, okay, I'm not hearing any distortion, so let's go to the max, see what we get.
Love is a rose, it's better not pink. Love is a rose, it's better not pink.
All right, so that sounds pretty good, except for that end part, that picket part, but we'll try to correct that with some manual alignment. All right, so for the manual alignment, the first thing we need to do is to X out of the script. And now what I want to do is export and render these two harmony tracks, you know, back into the project. So we'll go here, we'll go to render. Select the tracks, entire project. I usually use a wildcard to mono, MP3. And for this render, I want to add rendered items to new tracks in project. So let's do that. Render two files. I've done this a couple times, so let's overwrite. And it's just a sample, it's 22 seconds, so it was very quick. Here it goes. So here we are. Here are the two harmony tracks rendered back into the project. So let's move them up. Now, what I like to do when I'm doing this kind of work is to I insert a white track just to separate my working area from the area that I've already worked in. So let's turn these back into a yellow color. It's easier to see. All right. And let's also make them bigger. Right, so that's pretty good. So the first thing I want to do is put take markers in the reference track on some keywords in the chorus. So I'm just going to do like a demo, and I'm going to concentrate on the first three keywords, like love, is, and rose. So let's put love here in the front. I have keyboard shortcuts set up for this. Love. I think the is maybe somewhere about here. It is. And let's try rose. So let's give that a listen and see how we did. Love is a rose. Love is a rose. All right, so the rose, I think, is more like kind of in this waveform. Maybe it's about here. Try again. Love is a rose. All right, that's pretty good. Kind of happy with that. So now let's go to the first harmony track. And now we want to put stretch markers on the same keywords. So let's put a stretch marker on love. Again, I have keyboard shortcuts for that. Love is maybe about here. And rose, you know, I'm kind of guessing here. Let's try try that. Let's give it a listen. So that's actually pretty good. Now you do notice that you do hear the distortion now when you play the track by itself. You know, in combination with the other harmony track and lead vocal. You know, the distortion doesn't really come through, just the harmony feeling of the harmony track, you know, kind of comes through. So, not really a big problem. So, let's put the same markers on this harmony track. So, again, rose is right in the front. That one's easy. Now, kind of based on what I'm seeing in this track, it sounds like the is maybe about there. And the rose, you know, I don't know. Is it over here? Or let's try here. All right, let's give that a listen.
The rose, the rose.
All right, so I think the rose is really, I've got a mouse modifier that lets me move this around. So I think the rose is more like there. Try again.
The rose, you bet. The rose, you bet. The rose. The rose.
All right, so that's pretty good. So now the thing is to line them up. And so, you know, that's just a matter of you right click and select drag these two harmony tracks. And then what happens when you select both tracks, Reaper goes ahead and grabs both of those markers together. And you can just move them till the dotted line disappears. So that's pretty good. Let's do is, we'll go and catch that one and move it to this dotted line till that dotted line disappears. There you go. Now rose is kind of way off here, so let's catch it there and move it way up here. Right, so let's give that a listen.
Love is a rose. Love is a rose.
All right, so that sounds, you know, pretty good. You know, a lot better than it did, that's for sure. You know, so that's the technique that I used to do the manual, you know, alignment. You know, I kind of analyzed the chorus track, decided on, you know, what some of the key words were in the chorus. Set take markers on those keywords. I labeled them so I can kind of watch and hear and see how well I've positioned the take marker. And then the same thing with the stretch markers. And then you just kind of line them up. So now, of course, if you have like, you know, a long vocal or, you know, a long chorus, this manual approach might just be too tedious to do. Or maybe there might be a small section you want to line up. But for the chorus of this little song that I was doing, you know, this was fine. It was, you know, really not that bad, and you know, kind of fun to listen to the difference of the unaligned chorus and then putting it in alignment. You know, it's kind of fun to do. So that's the alignment I used for the mix that you heard in the beginning, you know, of this video. Oh yeah, and one more thing. While I was researching this, I came across a frequently asked question about when to do auto-tuning while doing vocal alignment. So I put some notes in the description below, and you may want to check that out. So with that, please comment, like, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
Love is a rose, better not pick it. Only grows when it's on the vine. Handful of thorns, no, you missed it. Lose your love when you say the word.